Okay, so now we have official news on Captain Marvel. In fact, they announced the writer. I'm not talking about this article, which was fake, that I said was fake, and it sure is. This will be the last time you ever see a sausage roll article on this channel, and I hope it's the last time for a lot of other people. This website has popped up mysteriously over the past couple of weeks. They have a lot of really sketchy, weird stuff on their website. I could just tell that they had a lot of bogus stuff on there. This looked bogus because they had this Kelly Sue DeConnick is writing Captain Marvel 2, which turned out to be absolutely a lie because she's not writing Captain Marvel at all. Coming out of The Hollywood Reporter, it turns out Megan McDonald is writing Captain Marvel 2. So I know everyone had a fun time trashing that sausage roll article. But like I said, it was obviously bait, and they wanted everyone to give that article promotion to promote their website because it's a new website. It made sense. But the website doesn't appear to have very much integrity. And, I mean, when you have articles about human meat burgers, I'm a little bit of a skeptic when it comes to your content. And it looks like I was right. So, now we know what's really going on with Captain Marvel. So let's talk about it. Let's talk about what's going on. But by the way, the Brie Larson stands over on Twitter, they're having a field day with this. Oh my God, we have new info. Brie Larson, my queen. These people, I give them ridiculous names because it's a ridiculous name for ridiculous people. The Brie Larson Defender Task Force. Literally, if you post any video or comments or YouTube links to Captain Marvel, these people are sitting there like constantly like refreshing Captain Marvel on Twitter so they can find stuff to go hound. It's really weird and kind of funny because I never respond to them, but I do enjoy their salt. I did a video on one guy, man. This guy posted 300 times a day talking about Captain Marvel. Really strange people. But anyway, getting back to Captain Marvel 2. This movie is going to be a really interesting watch for a couple of reasons. The biggest one that I'm going to really be fascinated with is how does it do? How does it perform? Because this time, they can't sandwich the movie in between Avengers Infinity War, which is really kind of the Empire Strikes Back of the Marvel movies, and then Avengers Endgame, which is the Return of the Jedi of the Marvel movies. It really is. I mean, that was, I would argue, this current generation's Empire Strikes Back and Return of the Jedi. It's basic. Marvel's basically what Star Wars used to be before Disney ran it into a dumpster and lit it on fire. Before then, that's what Marvel is right now. But anyway, how does this movie perform without that sandwich effect? We'll see. I don't think it's going to make nearly as much money as it did last time. I'll tell you that. Because people were hyped and excited for Avengers Endgame. And this movie was kind of positioned as you need to see it to really understand what's going on. They won't have the Avengers this time to prop her up. So we'll see what happens. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe it'll be the greatest movie ever. However, they're hyping up this writer, Megan McDonald. And I find that kind of interesting. I don't know anything about her. She's writing WandaVision, which I'm actually looking forward to. So if WandaVision is good, maybe that will mean something. Maybe they'll turn the ship around on this movie. For all intents and purposes, I like the Marvel movies. I'd rather they be good. Personally, I don't think Brie Larson has very good acting talent. So I don't know if she could play this character with better range, maybe, other than just having a face of wood. That would be nice. We'll see what happens. But I tried to look into Megan McDonald. I went to her IMDb, and there's not much on there. I don't even honestly know if this is the right one. There were two. One was an actress, and then there's this one. She only has, like, director and producer credit. I don't even know if she's a writer. Now, Well, she obviously is a writer. She's writing WandaVision in this movie. I mean, I just don't know what else she's written. I can't find any information on her. I will give her this, though. I looked her up on Twitter. She's not on Twitter. And I got to be honest, that says a lot when someone's not on Twitter. So maybe she's a normal person. Maybe she's a really good writer. And that's a big plus in my eyes that she's not on Twitter. But anyway, let's take a look. So Marvel is moving the action from the 1990s to the present day with scribe Megan McDonald. Now, that's a big thing. So they're not going to have that nostalgia time period. It really didn't help the movie in any way, in my opinion, because I didn't think the movie was very good. But they're moving it to present time. So that's another thing that it has missing. It's not going to be a time period movie, kind of like Wonder Woman's doing a time period thing. Now she's moving up to the 80s. That movie I'm actually very excited for. I think Wonder Woman, is it 1984? I forget what they're calling the actual movie. But that one's going to be really good. The trailer looked awesome. But anyway, a sequel to Marvel's billion-dollar grossing Captain Marvel is officially in the works. The company has tapped rising scribe Megan McDonald, a staff writer on the Marvel-based series WandaVision, to pen a script for a follow-up to the 2019 pick that starred Brie Larson and Samuel Jackson. McDonald is in final negotiations to seal her deal. I find it funny they put rising scribe. Like, what else has she done? Like, I don't know anything about her to say if she's a good writer or not. I really don't. But how is she a rising scribe? I can't find any information on this woman. Of course, that's another central theme to Captain Marvel 2, folks. Everyone that's making the movie is a female. We're looking for a female director. We've got a female writer. Like, that's going to make the movie better for some reason. I'm all for female directors and writers, but the fact that it's all females making the movie doesn't hype me up for the movie. Like, that's going to make it better. If anything, that just tells me that you're already making the film agenda-driven, which turns me off even more to the movie, by the way. So anyway, continue on. They say sources say that Anna Bodine and Ryan Fleck, who co-wrote and directed the initial film hit, will not return to helm the sequel, but are in talks to remain in the Marvel Universe and direct a possible Disney Plus series. Marvel's hoping to find a female filmmaker for Captain Marvel 2 and eyeing a potential 2022 release. Why don't you call Deborah Chow? I got to say, like, she seems pretty impressive. I mean, if you're going to go that route, they won't do that. They'll probably be some super woke lady. You call up Elizabeth Banks from Charlie's Angels. Hey, you did a fine job on that Charlie's Angels movie that was fighting the male patriarchy. You want to come in and write Captain Marvel? So details of any high-flying take were not revealed, but the new story will move the setting from the 1990s of the original movie to the present day. Marvel had no comment, which means they didn't want any of this movie to come out in the first place. The rest is just a recap on what the first Captain Marvel was, and then they talk about Guardians of the Galaxy 3 a little bit, Black Panther 2. Just the fact that during San Diego Comic-Con, Kevin Feige alluded to them that they're coming and even dropped mutants, but didn't reveal any info. So, final little piece of info here. McDonald is a relatively new writer and WandaVision, her first major credit. See, that's the thing. How can you call her a rising scribe if this is her first major writing credit? Maybe she'll blow it out of the water. I don't want to sit here and say she won't. I don't know anything about her. But, you know, so much for merit, I guess. I just find it funny that they're trying desperately to get a female filmmaker. Like, I mean, is it really that big of a deal? That's just this weird segregated mindset we have when it comes to writing people, doing voices for characters even. Like, you have to look like the person. It's just stupid. And it's really backwards and regressive thinking when you think about progress with relations and all this stuff. But, you know, well, we don't need to talk about that, I guess. So that's it. We want a Whammon-led movie. Whammon-led director, writer, producers. Make everybody a lady. Even the people moving the cameras. Let's make them all female. Why not? I'm sure it'll raise the quality of the film. Even the interns. Even the person in the bathroom that hands you the towels, let's make that person a lady too. Even the ones in the men room That'll be the break room, I guess, because no one will be in there. Well, wait, I don't want to say that. Let's just make the bathrooms inclusive. Anyway, I do believe, so Marvel didn't have a comment on this. No comment. But I think it's fairly obvious because of the timing of all of the Captain Marvel 2 writer videos. Thanks to that sausage roll article, I believe Marvel intentionally leaked this so that people wouldn't think Kelly Sue DeConnick is writing the movie. There you go. Sausage Roll is a garbage website. I hope nobody uses it after this and doesn't take them serious anymore. I mean, they literally have articles about people burgers. Talking about burgers that apparently have human meat. Like, I mean, come on. Obviously not a good website. So anyway, that's it. Captain Marvel 2 brings the agenda. That's... Well, it'll be fun when they finally start releasing trailers and stuff for that movie. I'm sure we're all going to have a good old time cracking on it. Because I don't think Brie Larson is good in this role. And the characters just, I don't care what they say. She's not popular. The comics don't sell. Maybe I'm wrong. You know, I don't know. I went into that movie. I did not feel very impressed. I thought it was a terrible movie. She was terrible in Avengers Endgame. They literally turned her into a Karen. The fact that they digitally changed her hair to be short, that was weird too. Everything about this character, I don't know. It's just this. If this is the future of the MCU, I'm scared. I'm telling you. Anyway, that is it. Thanks for watching, guys. Leave me your comments. What do you think? Do you think this movie will end up being really good? Did you like the original? How do you feel about all of this info? How do you feel about that sausage roll news that was obviously fake? And, you know, throw a like up. That would be appreciated. Comments and likes really help videos out. Also, please consider sharing the video. That helps out a lot as well. And make sure you're still subscribed. Subscribe if you're new. Hit that notification bell. And I'll see you guys on the next one. Peace. Also, if you want to help support the channel, check out my Teespring store. There's a link in the description. You can find some merchandise in there that you might want to check out. Also, take a moment. Make sure you're still subscribed to the channel. There's something going on right now, and they've been unsubscribing people. So just take a second and double check on that and subscribe if you're new.